project is an Erasmus Key Action 3 project, forward-looking, so we are looking forward. We try to do something that is not yet done. And starting from the world school and community approach, we try to pass from a standardized definition of bullying to specific definition of bullying. Bullying is not the same in different environments, in different schools, and even in different classes from the same school. And so we tried within this project to better understand the meaning of bullying by the students themselves. And then we tried to, instead of define prevention and intervention programs, we created through the project a flexible prevention intervention and intervention program. What does it mean to be flexible? It means that it's possible to create a sort of framework from where, starting from the needs of each class, of each situation, take what is really needed in order to educate and to work with the students in the and create also a strategy for bullying prevention. And in the SAFER project, the community was not meant an a supportive organization, but the community is meant as educating community. So not only health, social services, but mainly, as Fabrizio said before, not formal and informal educators that are very relevant for our children and for their growth. And then we pass from the general approach based on the promotion of values and social and civic competencies in school to a detailed and more specific educative strategy focused on situation linked to the real life of the context of each school. So we start from the definition of the methodology and a model. Then we create the tools for teachers and students and also parents in the community. We made a sort of pre-testing, and then we made an evaluation in order to draw some lesson learned that, as Piggy said before, were also at the basis of policy recommendation. The first part was the analysis of the best practices, because we started from what already was being done, and we examined 21 practices from nine countries. And from those practices, starting from the overall framework, we brought some other elements to our war school and community approach framework: the role of the parents and the community, the role of the school climate and well-being as strategic element, the developing of a peer approach culture, the need of continuous teachers training, friends as protective factors, and students as key stakeholders in the bullying prevention. Then, because we said, okay, we have to move starting from the real situation in each school, in each classes, we work through scenario-based questionnaire, through which we analyze the climate in the class and also the risk in case bullying is not yet inside the classroom, that it can happen because of certain behaviors or certain way of seeing the friendship and so on. Then we built the framework, the SAFER was based on social and civic competencies, promotion of common positive and democratic values, knowledge, ownership, and exercise of the fundamental rights, because we are convinced that being bullied means also to not have the right to be free, of course, which is one of the most important children's rights. And we saw all these elements from different lens, intercultural lens, social and civil lens, human rights lens, and global citizenship lens. On the basis of the framework, we created several materials that you can use, of course. Then I will give you the details. A teacher manuals containing lesson plans and 33 exercises that we call the learning experiences more than exercise. These learning experiences are split into pedagogical topics that are linked to the framework as well, like bullying seen from the student's eyes, identity in the community, social and civil competences in bullying prevention, teaching rights and value, how to teach students to communicate and solve conflict, empathy management and life skills, and how to speak and provoke discussion about bullying. Of course, we also provide the student handbook and the guide for parents and members of the communities, and the students also use the platform called Student Voice so that they had also the opportunity to share their experience during the piloting phase. We trained the trainers, and during the project lifetime we had 24 schools and 228 teachers participating in the program, but as we stated yesterday, the program is still continuing even if the project is over since last end of March. Then we had piloting and testing in 77 classes with 1,716 students and 509 involved parents, and also members of the communities like sport trainers, like churches, like, for instance, social clubs or cultural association, all the places where our children live and stays after school. And at the end, what Ian did in this project, Ian has been a sort of a privileged observer. Ian followed all the process from the very beginning, the research phase, till the evaluation of the training of the piloting with the school, and draw some lessons and transform such kind of lessons in policy recommendation. And yesterday during our board we decided to move forward and to present such kind of recommendation based on reality, based on real experimentations to our members, to the members, so to some members of the European Parliament, of the participating of the members of the network. And if you would like to help us and to give us more voice, please don't hesitate to contact the IAN network. And at the end we celebrated, of course, the success of the project through an international conference and some conferences, at least one conference in each of the participating countries. And we must say that also political representatives took part in these final events and also during the project. And more about SEFRA, you can learn in the SAFER website, and here you can see the address and the Facebook and the Instagram pages, and of course lot of newsletters that we produce during the project lifetime and that are at your disposal, together with the guide for teacher, parents, member of the community and students that you can download from the project website. Of course, we worked for them, and if we can't protect our children, then of course we have failed as a society.
Before leaving, I would like to underline that the test that we